datos fuertes del día de este Forex Day es David Aranzábal, CEO de FX for a Living, trader, empresario, conferenciante, colaborador habitual en varios medios especializados del sector. David tiene a sus espaldas más de 100 sesiones de trading en vivo. Ha realizado más de 1000 webinars de formación y es el organizador del Trading Week, del Forex Day y del Trading Accelerator. Ha realizado conferencias y sesiones de trading en vivo conjuntamente con grandes, muy grandes figuras del trading internacional como Boris Salzberg, Rob Booker o Bill Hubbard. Actualmente, bueno, también con Lex Van Dam, número uno. Actualmente es jefe de análisis técnico de Markets.com y en su intervención, sponsorizada por FX for a Living, técnicas de trading intradiario en el mercado de divisas, va a decirnos qué time frame seleccionar y con qué técnicas para tener un trading intradiario del más alto nivel y sobre todo del mayor éxito. David, adelante, todo tuyo.
Muchísimas gracias por la presentación.
Thank you for your introduction and I want to thank you all for being here today in this event. I hope you are having a great time. I hope you're learning a lot. And the third edition of the Forex Day, it's growing every year, more and more people coming, more speakers. Sometimes it's hard to do it better. Sometimes, you know, they've told me how you're going to make it better the following day, and more sponsors, and thanks to them, we can organize this kind of event where all the number ones are here. So, well, trading techniques in the intraday market. So last year we saw which techniques we could have in terms of monetary management to operate in the to do intraday trading. Today we're going to be less specific on the monetary thing, but a bit more on which strategy and which time frame can I use to make money, especially in the Forex market. So timing, the time of the day, is essential. And if we're going to do intraday trading, we should use the following time frames. This is a joke from Rob. I was... Look, Rob's there, see?
There are more like this, or this is the only one?
Solo esta, vale.
So just the one. Okay, thank you. I saw him, he was sitting on my laptop and say, you know, I have modified my slides. No, don't worry, it's fine. Well, we're going to do intraday training, so in 60-minute chart, in 15-minute chart, 5 minutes, and 1 minute charts. So here in the room, who's doing intraday? Raise your hands, please. Great. Lots of hands raising, that's great. I'm going to stand here because otherwise I can get all the lights on my face. So in intraday, which time frame do you normally use? Who's doing 60-minute charts? Great, 15-minute charts? 5 minutes? And the crazy guys that are doing 1 minute charts? Great, many of them, some of my students in fact. Well, that's great. It is very important, especially in the intraday market, but in every market, that we have to realize why in the intraday market, knowing what time it is. It's very important because if we are in the opening of the European session, if we are in the American session or in a session that's opened quite a long time ago, there are going to be, sorry, I was trying to place, or to show you the right slide, we are going to have different ways of understanding the markets. In this chart, I think it's really good, especially if you haven't ever if you are a swing trader and you want to enter intraday trading, there are more and more people doing, well, that normally we're trading in the short to long term, and what they come to me and say, David, I want to do some intraday training, do you think I can? And they tell me, this is the hours I walk in. Sometimes I tell them, no way, do something else. Or in some other cases, I tell them, well, that's perfect because you've got great opportunities. And there are many ways of approaching day trading depending on spare time and how our head works. It depends on how much we bear or how good we are bearing with anxiety and stress. So If we are walking on a 60-minute chart, the concentration, which is important as well. Some of us, we don't normally sit throughout the day, and some others just don't want to. Well, the concentration for 60-minute charts is low, and it increases, of course, as we go to shorter time frames. Of course, it's mere. In 5 minutes, is medium concentration. In 1 minute charts, what are we supposed to do? Turn off your mobile phone, right? And be extremely focused. However, in the 5 minute one, we might do something with something else we're doing on screen. So, unless we're driving a truck, we can have the 5 minute chart open and doing something else. If they have to do with the office, of course. If we don't have to go somewhere else, or so, well, we have wall compatibility. Well, in the 60-minute chart, it is compatible. In 50-minute, it is compatible as well. And it gets harder as we go to lower time frames. In the 5-minute chart, well, just what I said. You could, well, it depends on your work. If you're working on the laptop or on your computer, you can probably take a look at the 5-minute chart while you're doing it. And if we go to the 1-minute chart, of course, no. We have to realize that we can either do 1-minute charts or and nothing else, really. There's nothing else you can do. We just have to be just immersed in the 1-minute chart, and we could go to take or even shorter time frames. But I put my limit at the 1 minute. At the 1 minute chart, it will be more in line with the people who are doing tick trading. And well, how much time do we have to devote to trading? Well, I've got a job and I work from 6 o'clock in the morning till 4 p.m. Can I do day trading? Well, it actually depends. It depends on when you're free. So, if you go to a 60 minute chart, you will have to devote, the bigger the time frame, well, the longer the time we need to get the bars or the candles, so we have to keep on checking and controlling the market for a longer time to get the charts. So, we're talking about up to 12 hours now, which means that, 12 hours so I cannot do anything. No, that's not the case, because we saw previously that it requires less concentration. So you can do this as well as doing your other job. In the 15-minute chart, you're probably going to be there for about 8 hours. That's the European session or the American session. And you will be able to monitor it with the 15-minute chart. And with 15-minute charts in one session, the European or the American session, you have enough time to check all the patterns, if it was a trending market, and or if it was counter trend, or if there were consolidation patterns, anything. And well, if you're going to be trading with 5-minute charts, you will normally need about 5 hours. It's hard if you're in 5-minute charts to do a session or work for less than 5 hours. It's quite hard, because you do need the graph to express itself and get the different candles, so, and look at the different trends. And the one that requires less hours a day, but with more intensity, is the 1 minute chart. Even less, even with 2 hours, devoting our 2 hours to the 1 minute chart, it should be enough to do some trading and to find one, two, or three setups per session. Okay, that's stress. If you are doing intraday, who of the ones who are doing intraday now feeling that this is stressful? Nobody's raising your hand. You're extremely well trained, or what? You all watched, you were all here in the Lex Van Dam session, right? And you are all extremely well prepared.
Philip, you've got English translation.
Philip,
you
English, si quieres.
And
something else that you need is, you need to know is, am I going to be able to reach my weekly goals? depending on the time frame I'm working in. And well, obviously, if you go, if you go to a smaller time frame, there are going to be more opportunities because you carry out more operations, so you're going to be, it's going to be easier to get to your weekly objectives. In the 60-minute chart, you're going to have less operations per week, so it's going to be harder to be sure that a week is a long enough time frame to make sure that we can set weekly goals. So, well, let's now start now elaborating a bit more on this different kinds of trading. 60-minute chart. In the 60-minute chart, we can use longer charts. We can do swing trading. We can do it in 60-minute charts or in 4-hour charts. And one of them is going to be with Rob Booker. He's going to be closing today's session at 7:30. We're going to have a trifecta. Yeah, there you go. And however, the 60-minute chart can be useful in the intraday trading. Look, it's a beautiful chart because it's good for intraday traders and swing traders. It depends on if you're looking for a bigger trend and you're going to do swing trading, or if you're going to check the different movements throughout the day. And we're going to take a look at support and resistance, daily highs and lows, and weekly highs and lows, and double zeros that are great in the Forex market. How are we going to do that? There are two techniques that work great in today in the 60-minute chart, and they are especially good in pairs such as the pound dollar. And I'm talking about the following. They're opposite, but they have very similar setups. First of them is the second leg, and the second one is 100% retracement, or a U, finding a U pattern. Let's see where to find them or how to find them. Well, in the currency market, when there are news, if there are news and if the market it's in range because there are no news from the central bank, if there are no interest rates or and there's no inflation and they are not taking the purse anywhere, quite probably when there's this kind of a vertical movement, too long candles with closing very close to the lows, or closing very close to the highs if it's a bullish trend, there's going to be consolidation throughout the whole Asian session. And when the London market opens, if, well, here it was a fake one, but if the price starts to break the resistance we had in the channel, there's a very high probability of the price closing higher than and the price we had before, and it generates a U. So if you get one of those U shapes, you might have even 6 or 7 U's in a row in 2 weeks, or in 15 days.
Or you see no one, you don't see a one, and or they appear the 3 in a row. But they usually appear when there is uncertainty in the market. There is a piece of news that makes you think that there is a devaluation or extension movement in the sterling, for example, which is the best pair for together with the dollar. And then the market goes back to the starting point because nothing so important has happened that has made it break the extremes. So every time you see vertical lines quite well established, which are normal, and after news releases, then you have it recovering when the European session opens, and then you have that U movement. Here we see another example, and the U's, when they appear, they usually respect the resistance and support levels, and that's why you have that long-term movement. And the key for the 60-minute chart is very well supervised by the institutional movements, and it's very good at respecting the resistance and support levels. Lex has said that in the institutional channel they look at all at the macro level, and when the macro goes to the technical side, is not looking for the super indicator, it only looks at levels. The levels that you yourselves are watching, the same levels that you are taught at the first course that you take in supports and resistances, that the course free of charge that you have taken with supports and resistances, and you go back home and you start losing everything, and you say, oh, then you start to lose, and you say, that this is no good course, I have to take a course and pay. No, but we have to go back to what to the simples. The simple things are good. The simple things are the ones that work better, and we are going to start with this. We have Tondemar. Tondemar has a very good strategy. Every time you see a movement, a vertical move, very well established vertical moves, this is very simple. If they don't end up having a U movement, the possibility is that you have just the opposite. From the maximum, from the high to the low that you have had, if you take these peaks, let's imagine that they are 120, and you establish them from the high of the retracement that will be overnight to the future, and you get a level where you will probably during the next 24 or even 48 hours, the price is going to reach that level. That's Tondemar extension, and if you have 140 ticks of distance, you project them from the maximum that the pull bar has had to the future, and you will have a projection level that works quite well in pairs such as the sterling dollar one. Okay? You will see another example where we have had news in the States that have caused a vertical wall to appear here, and this whole distance from the max, from the high to the low, we projected to the future from the low of the retracement, and it gives us the projection value to which the price could get. It usually takes a little bit longer. It is usually during the first 24 hours, but it could even reach 48 hours to reach that level. All those who have been looking at the webinars, every daily webinars, we have seen these kind of things very often, and some of you are around. We have seen these projections where we said what the price could get to if it was a Tondemar extension or a double leg, what I call a double leg. This would be a leg and then the other leg, or the pullback or retracement of the U. These Tondemar levels very often takes us to the 161.8 of Fibonacci. If I take this extension and I project it to the future, as Tondemar says, if I do the same projection in Fibonacci, 161.8 usually coincides with this level. And when it coincides even more, perfect. We have a double indicator that tells us that the price could stop. 5 or 10? Okay, thank you. I'm not going to talk very much about 15-minute charts. I'm not going to talk at all about them. And, all those who have raised your hand that you are doing it in 15 minutes, so you are doing it wrong. No, absolutely not. But I just don't like 15-minute charts. It's just that. But if you are comfortable with 15-minute charts, it's great. One of the people who came to live trading that I did, Lex Van Damme and myself did, he only operates with 15-minute charts, and he said that he was doing excellent. And so, but I'm going to go directly to 5 minutes. What can we do with 5 minutes? There are two strategies that I like very much. One, Boris is going to discuss it, although he's going to discuss some other areas. It's Ajax, and it's an excellent chart, taking advantage of the news with 5 minute charts. But I'm not going to say anything because he's going to talk about that. And another one is to use my strategy, the Alicio, in the American session. Alicio. in the American session. Some people think that in 5-minute chats you cannot use the strategies that I teach, and in the but you can in the American session. Here we see, for example, that the price is achieving decreasing highs and decreasing lows. It makes a pullback, it breaks the trend line, it makes a swing, and it gives us a projection line of 5-minute charts, which has been a very excellent and satisfactory operation trade, because the stop loss was below this stop loss. As you see, it takes longer than a 5-minute chart to develop the operation, and we have had to be supervising it for several hours. But a 1-minute graph, it would have been something much quicker. But operating in 5-minute charts, we are not going to have a signal, and our signal is usually less frequent, perhaps 2 or 3 days per week. Well, let's watch a video, a very enjoyable video. The wheel goes from a car to another car to another car. And back there, the probability. So that's the same probability that you have of winning $1 million when you start doing this, mainly if you have $100 or $1,000. No, but jokes apart, let's go to the 1-minute chart. That doesn't mean that this is easier or more difficult in one time frame than in another. But Alicio, European opening, let's look at trading examples that we have done in the trading accelerator in Spain. And with the trading accelerator, we are looking for consolidations where the price is not achieving highs, there is no double ceiling, and he just turns around, and it just turns around and it goes back down. So we have Frankfurt, London. Frankfurt is at 8 in the morning, London at 9 in the morning, our Spanish time, and we see that the price has a double ceiling, and then the trend line from Asia is rotating. We filter it through the swing, and we have an entry here. That entry gives us a successful operation, and the technique that I perform, that I taught in this same Forex last year, how to chunk this whole trade in slices, so to speak. So it's taking partial profits. If you are interested on this, on looking at these trends and at these strategies, just tell me, because we can see in what conditions of the market we should be chunking or chunking it down, or you can even watch it in YouTube in some cases, in the videos of the Forex Day of last year. And mine last year, I think, was quite funny, wasn't it? Mainly for 5-minute charts. Okay. We have the same operation here for 5-minute charts, summarized. How we have reached the Asian high and the support of the Asian session, and this happens very often, every day almost. These are operations that were performed in one of the last sessions that we did in Las Palmas, where at some point in time, after Frankfurt, we saw a double ceiling, and so consolidation pattern, we break the trend line, we break the swing, and there. And then we have an entry here to come out in high probability areas. The price yet turns around, but thanks to what we explained last year, with the taking of partial profits, although it turned around, we ended up winning, and because this was just 20%, and so the net result was a win. And it's good to supplement last year's presentation with this one to see how, in the end, if you haven't chosen the correct trade, even if it turns around, it could be a break-even or a win in the end, because it's going to increase a lot the rate of success. That's what we want to achieve in the end. Then it goes down in London, and after 45 minutes, we have a new high, which is a divergence here. It breaks the trend line, and it breaks the swing at some point in time, and we have a trade here that this one was also a win, but with a greater extension. We had a longer room. We could leave it to Rome for a longer time, and then we have Frankfurt and London here, maximum highs and divergence. We enter short, and we had a loss there, but we had a second trade that, even though we missed it because we were in the another market, this is a book, by the book operation, where we have 1, 2, 3 breaking the trend and plummeting to the support line of the Asian session, the Asian market. And here we see again, this was with another pair, in another pair, and we took the fall here after quarter two, and this shoulder, head, shoulder, and breaking the lines, and we went in short. These operations were carried out a short time ago in Valencia. This was a live trading that we held in Valencia, and here we have a floor, a base. This is Frankfurt. It breaks the trend line. We go in, and then we go in short. This was not so successful because it plummeted a little bit, but we took profits, partial profits, and we were able to get out with profits. This is very similar also with the fall, the decline. Here we have shoulder, head, shoulder, and so it's an exhaustion pattern. We go in short, we break the trade in low probability areas, it becomes a support, the resistance becomes a support, then the resistance becomes a support, 1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 6 times. This happens very often. The simple things work very well. You have to look at support and supports and resistances, which are the weapon number one that any trader may have, either be it institutional, fundamentals, technical, whatever indicator you use. In the end, supports and resistances are going to signal high probability, high stop probability areas. And let's look at the one that we did yesterday, Lex Van Damme and myself in the live trading. Some of you were there yesterday. And if you look at, you have London, Frankfurt, and it seemed that nothing was happening. We did another operation in another pair where we got out with break-even, but it seemed not to be happening anything, but it created a floor 1, 2, 4, 5, 6 times, and once they break the LT, once they overcome the swing that we have as filter, we went in with the objective of reaching the resistance that we have in the Asian market, and it reached almost the last peak that we had in the Asian resistance. I closed it slightly before. I'm almost done, but you don't have to be too ambitious and too greedy, because you might be spoiling the whole profit taking of the whole rally. And so when we are approaching the resistance or the support areas, please don't take it to the limit. Leave it some room, leave it some margin, because it sometimes doesn't really reach the limit. And so with this, I conclude my presentation. Thank you very much, Susana, for taking care of the time. Thank you. And thank you all for being here.